Your thoughts on whether this guy is likely linked to others who may have helped him in this regard?
Well, it's unclear as to whether he was linked to others here in the United States. I think one of the real things we got to be taking a look at, who he was linked to in Pakistan and in Afghanistan. Mm-hmm. And to do that, we need strong relationships with the intelligence communities in those two countries, because they're the ones that are going to have the eyes and ears into the Taliban, into Al-Qaeda, and into ISIS. And they're the ones that, you know, can give us a tip that says, hey, we're hearing from our sources, there's an American in, you know, who's learning bomb-making skills.
Hello.
He's been there for 2 weeks, and he's heading back to the United States in March. That's the kind of information.
And then he comes back. Then he comes back, and it's not like he wasn't. You know, he was questioned by Customs and Border Patrol when he came back over. He'd been over there for a year at one point, and yet there's no screening. I mean, even if there was, we've seen some of the screening. Are you a terrorist? That's helpful. So you can understand Americans' frustration where they're like, the guy was in Quetta repeatedly. He was becoming more and more devout. He was becoming angry. He was openly talking about hating American culture. His dad said he was a terrorist. Okay, I get that he recanted, but that doesn't happen to the average person. And they're saying, we love our FBI, but we have to hold them to some higher standards.
Well, what we also do know, Megan, is that in the last number of years, the FBI and other law enforcement agencies, they've kind of become politically correct. Organizations that used to go in and train the FBI and other local law enforcement about the things to look for when you are trying to determine whether someone may have radical jihadist tendencies, that training in many cases has been eliminated because it was politically incorrect and uncomfortable, and we don't want to be perceived as targeting Muslims or, you know, folks from the Middle East or from Pakistan or Afghanistan. These organizations, or this training, has been purged from the FBI.
Mm-hmm. And so you've got a combination of, you know, you and General Hayden, who, of course, he was running the NSA program, where they were allowed to listen in only on a phone call that was between an American and a suspected terrorist. It's not just any American.
Correct.
And nine times out of ten, they weren't listening to anybody. They were basically just collecting so-called metadata. Anyway, that program, he's suggesting something like it, you know, some sort of something that would let us get more up into their business would be helpful. And you're saying that we've disarmed in the fight to a large extent. So, you know, where does that leave us? Because I understand we've got Donald Trump, we've got Hillary Clinton, but I mean, do you actually see a difference in the country's safety depending on what happens here on November 8th?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you know, domestically we have disarmed. We should rearm. Internationally, you know, take a look at what our intelligence capability in places like Libya and in Egypt. 6 years ago, these two countries were a rich source of intelligence, throughout northern Africa and into the Middle East. Egypt and Libya had fantastic intelligence organizations. When America partnered with radical jihadists, the Muslim Brotherhood, to overthrow Mubarak and to overthrow Gaddafi, we lost those two entire intelligence networks. We are now basically blind in northern Africa. We see less into the Middle East, and other people who in the past have partnered with us on intelligence capabilities are much more hesitant to partner with us. So we have disarmed domestically, and we have gone blind internationally in some key locations.
Hmm. Former Congressman Pete Hoekstra, good to see you. Thank you, sir.
Good, thank you.
Sid Nawaz is next. He's here in studio on her story. Plus, some of the biggest names in political forecasting are suddenly changing of Donald Trump. Larry Sabato is one of them. He's here to explain why and what's going on. And then it took about 6 hours to go from shocking to very ugly in the much publicized split between
shocked and social media is abuzz. People on the internet are going crazy because this was the Hollywood couple you thought would potentially be the one Hollywood couple that would make it through.